at the same time that, you know, Rudy Giuliani is having his insane press conferences and Donald Trump is talking about charts, the really scary, if long shot effort to nullify this election is ongoing. The Republican leaders of the Michigan House and Senate are expected to meet with President Donald Trump at the White House today as Trump continues that long shot bid to retain the presidency by overturning election results in key states such as Michigan. Now, those leaders, House Speaker Lee Chatfield and Senate Majority Leader Mike Shirley, couldn't be reached Thursday. I guess they were busy. Though both have said they have no plans exactly for any long shot maneuvers aimed at the Republican legislature naming an alternate set of pro-Trump electors for Michigan. But what you need to understand is, while they've said they're not going to just say, no, we're just giving the votes to Trump, even though that's not how the vote went, they've said that they won't. That is why they are being brought to the White House. That is the only reason this conversation is happening. And we can approach it maybe sort of laughing at how unlikely it seems like it will work. And also acknowledging that even if it does work, that by itself doesn't make Donald Trump president. But Donald Trump is trying to, like, forget not respecting the will of the people in terms of the popular vote. They're not respecting the will of the Electoral College either. They're just going to give him the win because they want him to win. If he succeeds in this, the GOP will even more officially have announced that they are effectively, they're done with democracy. It is now, if we can take power, we will, through whatever means possible or necessary.
John, you want me to break your heart even more?
What's that? Is that possible?
The only reason that Michigan's state legislature is controlled by Republicans is because of gerrymandering. In the 2018 state legislative elections, more Democratic candidates received votes.
Yep.
But because of gerrymandering, there are more Republicans in the state legislature than Democrats. So this is the theme that we need to expose, and that everybody needs to, like, find a way to collectively tweet the same thing over and over again. But, like, democracy is so far gone in America in this specific respect. Like,
yeah,
we are used to seeing, like, the popular vote doesn't necessarily translate to a win in the White House. That is insane. Now, the Senate should be, constitutionally speaking, the Senate really should be the only thing where, you know, because there are more Republican states than Democratic states, that's the only time where it should potentially be the case where there are more Republicans in the Senate than there are Democrats in the Senate. It's insane, but that at least has some kind of constitutional basis.
Yeah.
This is just gerrymandering. This is partisan drawing of lines, making it so that now we already talked about the popular vote and the not determining who the president is. Now it's not even the vote within the Electoral College system as we come to understand it. And not only that, the way that the Electoral College is potentially designed in this very weird, tenuous argument that, like, oh, if there's too much fraud, we should let the state legislature decide. That's only under the assumption that the state legislature will be the same party makeup as the popular vote in the state. But that's not the case. So we are so far gone from what any reasonable person would describe as democracy.
I agree.
Because and now Trump is trying to exploit that in a way that even the most corrupt politicians and Republican presidents we've talked about in the past have not done. Why?
Exactly.
Because he's a little baby boy and he don't like to lose. And all the other little baby boys who are trying to use him but don't think he'll be able to secure the presidency, all the other Republican politicians who aren't calling him out for it, they're complicit in the coup that he's trying to do right now on Fox News.
Yeah, I mean, I remember in the wake of that election in Michigan, I don't remember exactly what the numbers bar are, and lots of states are like this. It's just that this is one of the worst ones where they got, like, I don't know if it was 57% of the vote in congressional races or 60%, and they got like 40% of the actual seats. It's madness. It's madness, yeah. And that's why, you know, we occasionally do dives into it, but no, the system from floor to ceiling is rigged in ways that uniformly advantage Republicans in anti-democratic ways. So this is what's happening in Michigan. They're saying they're not going to overturn it, But the president of the United States is trying to get them to overturn it. And as I said, Michigan wouldn't be enough. So what do you know? They're not stopping at Michigan. Two sources tell CNN, this is breaking news this morning, there are discussions currently underway with the president about inviting Republican state legislatures from Pennsylvania to the White House. It's not clear if those invitations have been extended yet, but President Trump has expressed interest in doing so as he tries to, and take a look at this, insert himself into the vote certification process. That's all he's doing. He's just inserting himself into the process. No, he's trying to convince multiple states to defy the will of their own voters in elections that were not remotely close. In Michigan, Biden is up by 156,000 votes, 2.8%. This isn't 0.2%. This isn't automatic recount. This isn't optional recount. This is a big win. Pennsylvania, I believe, is even bigger. These are not close cases. This is just the math they've done. We need those electoral college votes. Those states happen to have Republican state legislatures. So we don't care if Biden won by 100 million votes in those states. We're gonna take it if we can. And the process is underway. They are trying to steal this election by stealing those states.
Yeah, it's insane. And so Trump has yet to provide actual evidence in any material way of Democrats getting rid of votes, burning votes, fraudulently submitting votes. We in this segment have given tons of evidence that that's exactly what Trump's trying to do. He is trying to burn hundreds of thousands of votes. And to even that thing that you say is not like wildly incriminating, he's trying to insert himself into the vote certification process, something that you determined to be a euphemism because, yeah, it is much worse than that. Mm-hmm. Even the euphemism is bat-ass crazy. The idea that one of the candidates wants to be the person in charge of certifying votes. That's why we have the system that's set up the way it is. That's why Trump's attempts have failed, because the system's fine. The system has Democrats and Republicans doing the same thing to kind of offset each other during the process so that partisanship doesn't necessarily enter into it. The partisanship is in the drawing of districts, but in this situation, court after court, Trump appointed judge has said, even I can't give you back the solid you gave me, because that is crazy. This is, believe it or not, still America.
Exactly. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.